It's been several weeks of people self-isolating and social distancing, washing their hands, not touching their face, all of these kinds of things. And there's been a profound impact on the businesses and people who work in those businesses. What we're seeing is some flattening of the curve, and that's exactly what we want to see. We want to see that the spread, the doubling, is up to 16 days now. Instead, it was doubling every 3 days at one point. So we're seeing some progress, and we're now starting to have a look at how we restart the economy, how we do it in phases. Everything that we do is being driven by the actual data. And as the finance minister, Minister Rod Phillips, says, the plan that he brought out this week is a pathway. It's not a calendar, because we have to have the data to be able to move down that pathway. I'm optimistic that we're going to be able to do that. I'm part of what's called an essential businesses committee. There are six of us, a subcommittee of cabinet, that are looking at different areas of the economy and what would be able to open in different phases to make sure that we're striking the right balance and making sure that we're keeping people safe, but at the same time, letting the economy move forward. The decisions are being made primarily by the provinces, and it's a coordinated conversation. Ottawa is part of that conversation. The premier has been clear that we don't think the federal government needs to enact the Emergency Act. And at this point, although we do need their assistance, they are the ones with access to finances, and we've coordinated very closely. I think people are pleased to see that municipal, federal, provincial, county governments, we're all working together. There really is no partisanship in this. We want to make sure that we're getting the resources to the people who need them the most. I think everybody feels that they've been doing their part, and as the weather turns, it's harder to continue to socially isolate, and people want to get out there. We just ask that we continue on the path that we're on, because we need the numbers to hold. We need to know that we're containing. But my constituents are asking a lot of questions. We're helping tons of people through the programs, federal and provincial. We're working closely. My office is fully staffed and working, but we're doing it remotely like so many other places. And we're working closely with Doug Shipley's office. So if somebody phones and they have a question, it doesn't matter whether it's federal or provincial, or if there's a municipal program, we'll help guide people through that. The courts have been affected substantially, but in all of these things, it's difficult for people, but there are opportunities to improve the system. And I like to say we've improved the courts 25 years and 25 days. We've modernized them. We're using electronics in ways that we have never used them before. Bail hearings and remand hearings are happening virtually, thousands of them over the last couple of weeks. And what that means is that we're not moving people around. We're not transporting accused, and we're getting their hearings done in a timely manner. So it's that kind of thing. We're starting to see, in conversation with the Chief Justices, there's a Chief Justice of Ontario and one for the Superior Court and one for the Court of Appeal. We're all working closely, our offices, to find a better way. And I can tell you, just by way of example, the amount of technology that we've brought to bear to make these things work, just in the Attorney General's office, we've purchased 625 additional conference call lines. 600 plus laptops have been leased, digital recording devices. We've expanded technology across the system, all across the province. And quite frankly, we will not go back to the way that it was entirely. This is transformational, and we're going to make it more accessible for people. Last week I watched a divisional court hearing. I would never have been able to get there, but I could have it on the side of my desk and hear what the arguments were just as an observer like everybody else, and all sorts of things. Access to justice is going to be improved through this. When we started and we had to scale back, we dealt, of course, with the urgent matters first. And guidance on this is with the Chief Justices. It's not up to me to say, here's what you can hear and here's what you can't hear. The Chief Justices do an assessment based on what they can do. I'll give you an example. The Court of Appeal, they're operating entirely virtually at this point, and they are comfortable doing that. The Superior Court and the Ontario Court of Justice were not quite fully scaled out yet. And so the timing of when we're all back to normal in terms of being able to manage the case volume, we're not there yet. But We're trying to be cautious. We also want to make sure that people have the right forum for their case. These are significant matters that impact their daily lives, that impact their entire lives. So we are moving fast, but we want to make sure we hold on to the core principles. The people are open to doing things in a way that they weren't open to before, because we had to do something. And they're seeing that it works. They're seeing that we're able to do these things. And one example, under the emergency orders, you can now do wills virtually. So if I was a practicing lawyer, if I was in a law firm, I could be watching you sign your will, and we could witness it remotely. There's a process for that. We'd say, again, safeguards, make sure that there's no duress and somebody's being forced to do anything. But we're allowing that to happen. And that, quite frankly, is how the kind of thing we should be looking at to work in the modern day. To my constituents in Barrie, Springwater, or Medante, call my office if you have questions. We are there. We're working. Phone and email. We'll get back to you very quickly. We want to help people. We want to help navigate. If there are ways that you think that we can be helping, please let me know. And if you have ideas on priorities in terms of reopening the economy and where you think we should start, and quite frankly, people who are living the experience often have the best ideas. So please do not hesitate to send me an email or leave a voicemail, and we'll take the input and we'll answer any questions that we can.